Hi, and welcome to Introduction to Asset Inventory and Network Discovery. My name is Erez Mizrachi, and I'm a Global Black Belt for Defender for IoT. In this video, I will go over the basics of network discovery and asset visibility, one of the first foundations of the Defender for IoT capabilities. So when connecting Defender for IoT within a few minutes, you get a full map of your network. In the map that is divided into three parts, the corporate enterprise part, the supervisory part, which supervises the process layer, and the process part, the process layer part, you see all the devices that are communicating in your network. While zooming in, you are able to define or to see what is the type of the device based on the icon of it. You can see the name of the device, where applicable, the IP address, and if it has alerts, active alerts on this device. You can see who is communicating with who. For example, if you press on a device, you can see with which other devices this device is communicating with. Going in for a deeper information, you can right-click a device and view its properties. In these properties, you can see, for example, the IP address, the MAC address, the vendor. What are the protocol that this device is using? What is the type of the device, and the vendor and the operating system? You can also see if this device is authorized, meaning if you authorized it to be part of the network, or it's a new device which is not yet authorized. And also if this device is allowed to scan the network or to program other devices. So you can see that in this example for the HMI. You can also go to PLC, the same way, view properties, and you can see all the information that are applicable. Also, if this device has a backplane, you can see in this example, it has one rack and slot number two. You can see also firmware version, hardware vision, model, module version, the vendor, and the type of it. There are other devices which has more than one slot. And this is a good example of that. This is a Rockwell PLC, which uses Ethernet IP. You can see here that it has different slots, and there are cases where you can see that behind this slot, slot number zero in rack number one, you see here it says 17. If you press on view on map, you will be able to see another network of PLCs that resides at the bottom of this PLC, and you can also go and see their information, each and every one of them. So this allows you very deep visibility of the assets, the devices in your network, and also a very useful capability is understanding how these devices are communicating. So if, for example, I will select the HMI and press the control key and select also a PLC, and I will open the properties window here, you can see a connection details button. Once I press this connection details, I can see, first of all, the communication between the two devices. You can see it here in the graph, the total bandwidth. I can see if it's a specific protocol or a port, you will see it here, and the bandwidth. What's most important here is the pattern. So that I can see that, for example, this device has specific pattern. If I see here that, for example, a huge peak now or something which is not expected, then this is a mark for me to go and investigate further, because this tells me that we are deviating from a specific pattern. On top of that, you can also search for devices if you are looking for a specific device, you can search for it here. For example, I can press this one and then go directly to this device. I can also do some more filtering, very advanced filtering options, simply by clicking these three lines on the left side. I can highlight specific devices, or I can filter specific devices. So for example, if I want to see all the devices that are using DMP3, if I press the highlight, you will see them in blue. If I press the filter, the map will filter it for you. So you will see only these devices here. So you can see here engineering workstations, HMI, and PLCs. You can also do that for a specific other protocols. For example, if you want to see a Modbus PLC, then again, you select Modbus and filter, and it filters. You can also do some filtering based on subnet for if you want to see a specific devices which reside in a specific subnet. You just, again, select the subnet. You can see here we have these three devices. You can also do that based on specific protocols, IT protocols like FTP, or if you want to see devices that are using TeamViewer, you can also do that. Very important also is to see cross-subnet connections. Cross-subnet connections allows you to see which devices are communicating between different subnets. And this is very important because when we are looking for attacks, or when an attack take happen, a cyber attack, we usually see that lateral movement also within the same subnet, but also between subnets, because especially in OT and ICS or IoT networks, the attack comes usually from the corporate, from the internet to the inside, and then they move between subnets until they are reaching the production subnet. So this is also something that you can do from this filtering. And this, if you look at the again at the higher picture, so this is the map of all the devices, and with all the information that you can get out of it. On top of that, there is the device inventory. Device inventory allows you to get a full inventory of all your devices in the network. Inside this inventory, you can first of all do specific filtering. If you want to filter, let's say, only by PLC, then you can filter here, say equal and a PLC. And when you apply, you will get a list of only the PLCs. You can also save this search for later on use it again, this filtering. You can export everything into a CSV file, which can be used to manage it externally. And you are also able to forward everything to a CMDB system. All the information that we are gathering from the packet inspection of all the packets of these communicating devices, you are able also to enrich your CMDB system. Last thing is that you can use the specific report mined from the data that we are seeing from the packet. In this example, for a specific device, you can select a report which brings all the information for this device. And you can see, for example, this one is the S7 PLC. You can see information about the model and the firmware version. You can see the asset activity, when was it last seen, the open ports of this device, what is the MAC address. You can see the specific data blocks and functions that are being used by the OT protocol here, S7, and control functions and racks and slots. So we are grabbing a lot of information per each asset, and everything is visible to you. Also, of course, a list of CVEs for the specific device. So when we are saying that we have a very good asset visibility and network visibility, it means that you can get a lot of information per each asset and per the network as a whole. And combining this information per asset and the device inventory and the map gives you full visibility into your network. So this was an introduction to asset discovery and network visibility. If you have any further questions, please feel free to email me, rsm@microsoft.com, and I will be happy to assist with any question.